natural resources. Am I right? The MD of Ecom4 permit me to stand on the already established protocol. We are very glad to have all of you here. It's a synergy, actually, between the government and the government. In the sense that you are the main people that are going to be the drivers of this process. We are just the other way to take from you so that there won't be wastage, so that there will not be losses, just like what my colleague has said there. When I came in, I heard him say that. The facility we have is a very elaborate one that is actually meant to process 21,000 birds per day. It's very huge. Even with the poultry farm we have at Pamo, the state government has at Pamo, we won't be able to supply all the birds, even if we run at full capacity. We won't be able to satisfy the demand of the factory. Because we have 6 large pens, and each of that pen has a capacity of 30,000 beds. So, you know, it's supposed to be 180,000 beds. Now, if you factor maybe 10% mortality rate, that gives you like 18,000. We should be able to have a lot of beds to service the factory, but that's not enough. And that's why we feel that farmers should be able to cultivate or grow more beds so the government can take from them, process in the factory. They're going to be win-win from both directions. The farmers will win, the government will win, everybody will win at the end of the day. I'm sure that's the reason why all of us are here today. I believe that with all of us put our heads together and cooperate, and maximally, we should be able to, you know, drive this process to the end. And at the end of the day, as I said earlier, His Excellency meant well when he established that. But when he started it, initially, some people, like even as the Commissioner for Industry, I didn't actually understand what he was trying to do. But you know, he's a man that sees tomorrow. He knows that actually there are going to be challenges in terms of, importation of most of these things. Because if you check now, the imports of food has actually reduced. Because the federal government itself has placed embargo on a whole lot of things, which means that some of these things that we're importing into the country are now going to be grown, are now going to be produced locally. So that implies that beyond what we're going to do here, a lot of people that also want to go into maize cultivation, which also form the major raw material for, you know, the production of feed that the bears will eat. A lot of it still have to be, you know, cultivated domestically. Because if we check the import component of that one already, you discover that because of the high exchange rate between the naira and the dollar, it's discouraging a lot of farmers from even importing it into the country. And also from the northern part of the country, they were also growing yellow maize so much. Because of the insurgency in the northern part of the country, that has drastically, you know, reduced the cultivation of maize. So the onus is now on us for the southern part of the country to also go into that area also, knowing quite well that the market is large enough to accommodate everything you produce. Because it's a full value chain, so we need to take advantage of that full value chain so that at the end of the day, we'll be able to, you know, get the maximum benefit from what we are doing. So we thank you so much for coming here, and we believe that it's going to be an interactive session. Everybody will benefit from it, and at the end of the day, we'll all be better off for it. Thank you, and God bless you.